Congratulations to the graduating class of 2020. What an amazing finish to your senior year. No one could have imagined it would have ended with a governor's proclamation for the schools to be closed for the last 3 months. You were asked to keep working on your academics and to finish strong. You did just that. Graduating from high school under such unique circumstances shows to all that you are not just academically prepared to start the next phase of your life, but that you are strong, focused, and flexible enough to accomplish your goals under such epic circumstances. I am confident that each one of you has what it takes to accomplish your dreams and goals. I wish you the very best as you embark on the journey. Continue to utilize the skills you have learned while in school, and most especially during these past 3 months. I would like to leave with you a few quotes from a kind and wise man, Mr. Rogers. He says, "Some people think that friends are always happy, always having fun. Well, that's not true. Friends often have hard times and sad times, but friends can come together again and again and build a stronger and stronger friendship between each other. As you go your separate ways, know that you will always have the friends you have made in Colfax. We all need a listening ear now and then. Don't forget your Colfax friends and family are here for you when you need us." Mr. Rogers continues to say, "I trust that you're growing in ways that will help you with whatever feelings you may have when you're a child and when you're a grown-up. I hope you're able to respect whoever you are inside. You are now entering the world of being adults. Always remember where you come from. You represent your family, your school, but most importantly, yourself. You will hear many comments or judgments from others throughout your life. Always know that the most important opinion is the one you have of yourself." If all of us can emulate the advice given by Mr. Rogers, we will have much to be grateful for throughout life. Good luck always, and I look forward to hearing of your great accomplishments. Go Bulldogs!
Congratulations, graduates, as you survived COVID at construction this year. I know it wasn't ideal, but we are proud of you, and we are proud of your accomplishments. When I told my wife that I was writing my first graduation speech as principal of Colfax Junior Senior High School, she gave me the look. Not sure why. I've seen it before, but never for a speech. I would also like to thank Google, Wikipedia, my Siri, and the inventor of copy and paste. In all seriousness, having given some thought to the privilege it is to speak before you, I promise to keep it simple, short, and to the point. I need to tell you that as hard as you have worked to sit here today, I feel that I owe it to you to do this for you. No matter how nervous I feel, and this is an opportunity to send you off and into the real world and to tell each of you how proud we are of you. I will discuss the past, present, and future while giving you a bit of advice and words of wisdom that you can take with you. Now, looking at this graduating class, I am sure there are some looks of what's next and where to go from here. But first, let me mention the past, and maybe by the end, you will have a better idea of what you have accomplished here today. When the graduating class of 2020 arrived at the Junior Senior High campus 6 years ago, it was your first experience in the big school across the street. There were questions about what to expect and where to go, who different teachers were, and what classes were the most fun. Well, you all made it here, and here you are, in front of all the people who are here today to celebrate this marvelous occasion with you. For a majority of you, this is the biggest day of your life and should be one that you remember, take many pictures of, and cherish for years to come. Many of you will continue your education at a trade school, 2-year school, a 4-year university, in the military, and some will enter the workforce. Whatever you decide to do, remember this. Be proud of where you came from, and be proud to be a Bulldog. There are few, only few, who can say they graduated a Bulldog and will be one of those graduates in a very short time. While here, you have left your mark in athletics, through community service, but most importantly, in academics, where this graduating class has amassed roughly $608,000 in scholarships and where many plan on continuing their education. I, for one, am very proud of you, as I am sure so are all the people who helped get you here today. Next, for the present, enjoy the moment. Today is your day and a milestone. Author and former president, college president, L. Thomas Holcraft once said, "The past is a guidepost, not a hitching post." Since today is the start of a new adventure, take this advice and run with it. Don't get caught thinking of the past, but look towards the new journey that you will embark on and use what you have accomplished the last 4 years of high school to guide you on the rest of the journey. Finally, for the future, and my own bit of advice for you. As I stated earlier, many of you decided to continue your educational journey. Please take advantage of your opportunities, build relationships with those who you can trust, and attend class on a regular basis. Former Green Bay Packers head coach Vince Lombardi once said, "The difference between a successful person and others is not the lack of strength, not the lack of knowledge, but rather a lack of will." Looking at this graduating class, there is one thing they are not lacking. That is will. Even though you have taken different paths personally to get here today, you all share one thing in common. You are the only 2020 graduating class of Colfax High School. Use the bonds you have formed over the years and to continue them for the next 40. Attend class reunions, brag about your successes, families, and career, cry over failures, learn from them, and be stronger for it. In conclusion, thank you for the past 6 years, seniors. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to know you and to speak at your graduation. I am proud of you. We are proud of you. And don't be strangers. We'd like to see your successes. Go forth and do great things. Be tomorrow's doctors, lawyers, educators, and anything else you want to be. There are no limits, and nothing should limit you. To all the seniors, I leave you with this and the new chapter you are about to write. An unknown author once said, "When writing the story of your life, don't let anyone else hold the pen." Thank you.
Hello, family, friends, and graduates of the Colfax High School Class of 2020. My name is Caden Brown, and I am this year's valedictorian. To start off, I would like to congratulate my fellow classmates. Together, we somehow made it through these unpredictable and troubling times. No, I do not mean COVID-19. I mean the last 4 years of high school. Through every curveball thrown at us, including going through an entire construction process and nearly an entirely new faculty, we braved the uncertainty and overcame a multitude of obstacles. In the wise words of Ralph Emerson, "It's not the destination, it's the journey." But who are we kidding? The journey wasn't great, and the destination is much better. In any case, I am proud in each and every one of us for making it to this point. Of course, our success wasn't made on our own. We had more than enough help along the way. Each person who was part of the Colfax High School faculty was a key part in our success, as well as all of our loving parents. I would like to take a moment to recognize a few members of the Colfax High School faculty. Mr. McGrath and Mr. Penwell, thank you for being the best bromance in Colfax High School, besides, of course, Nick and Blake. You truly made the classroom an enjoyable experience between Punday Monday and Mickey Mouse Clubhouse on game days. I believe, on behalf of the whole class, I can say, you guys truly could brighten up even the worst days. I'll truly miss the memories we made. Oh, and don't forget, Brandon and I still want our 2v2 basketball match. We'll be ready. Mrs. Vogler, thank you for believing in each of us, no matter how hard we struggled. You made us think critically and helped us out of our comfort zone. There is no other classroom I would rather fail a math test in than yours. Each lab we did helped give a hands-on and practical application of what we were learning in the classroom. You made math and science fun, something many teachers aren't able to do. Mrs. Boyd, thank you for checking in with all of us on a constant basis this year. Even if the only way you could get us to stop talking was to yell at us, you were the best counselor a class could ask for. You stuck your neck out for us, and we appreciate it greatly. You put forth the extra effort every day to ensure we were on track to graduate. None of this would have happened without you. Mrs. Bogle, thank you for being a second mom to all of us. I know when you took time out of your lessons to roast us, it was just one of the many ways you showed love. Especially that one time, I forgot I had your keys in my pocket and left you stranded for half an hour. You forgave me and laughed about it. Without you, I don't think I would have made it through senior year. We made more memories than we could have ever asked for. From teaching us the basics about family health to teaching us how to cook, you gave class a purpose, kept us on our toes, and always made class a worthwhile experience. To each and every member of the numerous sporting program staff, thank you for dedicating your time to us after work. There aren't a lot of people who are willing to do what you do. You have formed us into better men and women, whether some of us want to believe it or not. Needless to say, we didn't like the Monday mile, but it helped us at the end of the day. The lessons we learned through constant perseverance and pain will never be forgotten. The memories from our first to last were trying at times, but will stay in our hearts forever. As for the rest of the Colfax High School faculty, thank you for your hard work and dedication to our school. What you have done for the students has not gone unnoticed, and we appreciate you all. Parents, don't think I forgot about how much you mean to us graduates. Without you by our side to push us every day, we wouldn't be where we are today. I know there have been a few bumps in the road, like Midnight Rider or Bible Camp, but we moved on and used it as a lesson. To the younger audience watching, just know, sneaking out in the middle of the night to go ride your dirt bike in the dunes with your friends will get you in more than a lot of trouble. On a serious note, your continuous support throughout this year has been outstanding. At the beginning of the year, a devastating virus took over our grade, senioritis, the ultimate downfall of any graduating class. Thanks to your continuous love and care, we were able to fight through it and graduate. Thank you, parents, for everything you do. I would also like to give a personal thank you to my mom and dad. I had a goal to be on this podium on graduation day, and I made it. I could have not have asked for a better set of parents to push me to my limits, guide me through various life lessons, and be the backbone of my high school career. If it weren't for you two, I would not be standing where I am today. Thank you both. Seniors of Colfax High School, we must face the truth and challenges of life. After graduation, our lives are changed forever. We can no longer rely on our parents to cook us meals and do our laundry. But parents, it would be nice if you could spare money every now and then for top ramen. Whether you are going to college, the workforce, the military, or anything else, we all must accept the inevitable changes that come with it. From this point on, we are simply the class of 2020. Some of us may never see each other again, and that's okay. It's time we find ourselves and carve our own path for the future. Life is an improvisation. You have no idea what's going to happen next, and you are mostly just making things up along as you go. I wish the best of luck to you all. There is no other class I would rather graduate with than you guys. We are the class of 2020, the class that survived the coronavirus and the year that it got real. Thank you.
Good morning, family, friends, faculty, and my fellow classmates. When I first sat down to write this speech, I had no idea what our graduation would look like. For all I knew, I could have been saying this speech over a Zoom meeting, waving at my classmates through the screen of a computer. Turns out I was semi-correct. Now I'd like to thank everyone that put in all the hard work to make our graduation possible this year, even if it isn't as traditional as we originally expected. Due to the construction that is being done to our school, we already knew that our graduation was going to be unique compared to any other Colfax graduation we had seen in the past. Our class has learned to take change with a spoonful of sugar. It helps the bad news go down. As a child that grew up with High School Musical on TV all the time, I had originally envisioned high school being completely different than it actually turned out to be. Let me tell you, we don't stick to the status quo. There aren't many Troy Boltons or Sharpay Evans around here. I figured once I got to high school, I would find the one thing that I loved doing and would run with it. Just like how Troy found basketball and theater. But it turns out, high school didn't help me find what I love to do. But it did help me find what I don't want to do. I'm beginning to learn that it's okay to not understand what your future holds. Surprises are around every corner, and you have to learn how to roll with it. Go with the flow, so to speak. I believe high school is where you make mistakes and learn from them. I have made many mistakes in high school, and I'm sure most of my classmates can relate. But I am glad for every single misstep along the way. Each mistake and experience we go through helps us grow and mature. It is not the worst thing to slip up or do something wrong. It honestly might turn out for the better. I've learned more from failure than I ever learned from success. I always tried my best to be perfect in everything I do, but that led to me being afraid of failure, which made me afraid to try new things that I believed I may not be good at. It wasn't until recently that I learned life isn't all about being successful or doing everything right. It's okay to fall down and try again. You have to pick yourself up and laugh it off. A saying that really got to me was, 100 bad days makes 100 good stories. Something awful may happen and it may be rough in the moment, but later you can laugh about it or tell others of your experiences. All of those stories can make you a really interesting person to be around. So that one bad day could end up being a tale you tell others, either for entertainment or as a lesson. The past is where you learn the lesson, and the future is where you apply the lesson. Now is the time that each of us will be moving towards different chapters in our lives, either heading straight to the workforce, military, college, or etc. Each of these futures can be scary and uncertain, to say the least. A question that may be racing through many of our minds is, what are we going to do with all of this future? I can tell you what you should be thinking instead. What am I going to do right now that'll make me happy and provide a future that I can only dream about? It isn't as simple as taking one big leap towards the thing you want most. You must start building your ladder so you can slowly begin to climb your way to what you want in life. You can't go back and change the beginning of your story, but you can start where you are and change the ending. Forrest Gump had the right idea when he said, "Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get." You must learn to take time to appreciate the journey. It's exciting to think that some of the best moments in our lives haven't even happened yet. We are all going to go off and blaze our own paths. I know that I can speak for all of us when I say that we appreciate every single person who has helped us become the people we are today. The future is rocky and uncertain for many of us right now as we learn about what it takes to become fully responsible for oneself. Look at the journey as an opportunity. Find what you want, make it happen, and shock everyone. Don't be afraid to stumble and make mistakes along the way. Those mistakes eventually guide you to better things. I'd like to thank my family, friends, and teachers for guiding me through life thus far. Each one of you has been a considerable influence in my life, and I am beyond grateful. I'd also like to acknowledge each one of my classmates. I'm blessed for all the memories I will forever hold on to here in Colfax. Here's to hoping that we all make something out of our lives and live to be happy. Thank you for your time.
Thank you everyone for attending Colfax Junior Senior High School 2020 graduation. We would like to take a moment to honor our country with the playing of our national anthem. Before we call our graduates across the stage, I'd just like to take a moment and thank a few people who have made this possible. The Whitman County Fairgrounds, the City of Colfax, Washington State Patrol, Whitman County Sheriff's Department, Colfax Police Department, Colfax Fire Department, Colfax Computer, KCLX Radio, Avidex, Leo's Photography, all the parents, students, and community members of the City of Colfax, and of course the staff at the Colfax School District. This has turned into a very non-traditional setting for us. I appreciate all the support that our graduates have gotten as they have survived construction, they have survived COVID-19, and we look forward to very, very bright things for their future as we send them off this afternoon to whatever it might be that they decide they want to do. And I can't thank them and all of you enough for that. If we could just give everybody a nice round of applause for all the extra support we've gotten with this. I love the horns honking, so let's do this. As a graduate gets announced, if we could just get some horns honking for them, we'll get this thing going. And got a little surprise at the end for everybody. Graduates, if you would please watch Caden and Caitlin, they're gonna kind of demonstrate how we're gonna do this since we didn't get an official practice. And so I do wanna give a big shout out to also Mrs. Cooper and Mr. Clausen for helping with all of this. And once again, this wouldn't be possible without just a number of people working together to make this possible for our students and your students. So I'm gonna hand this over to Mrs. Boyd. She'll be reading our names today for us, and we'll go ahead and get this thing started.
Thank you. Caden Logan Brown. Caitlin Marlene Cornish. Logan J. Aussie. Kyle Lee Walter. Thank you. Avery Joe MacLight. Maya Allison Ensley. Lily Mackenzie Swan. Daniel Jameson Schlader. Cheyenne Autumnly Tackett. McKenna Ann Lomax. Cole Charles Bearlocker. Savannah Autumn Sanders. Thank you. Lauren Riley Kennedy. Hayden Joanne Fulks. Jenna Lee Getz. Sydney Michelle Island. Cal Robert Lewis. Brandon Carl Lustig. Blake Michael Holman. Cotton Ross Booker. Crystal Dawn Parker. Ari Elizabeth Tapana. Jacob Hahn the Third. Jonathan Whitfield Nelson. Shaya Elaine Antoine. Nolan Thomas Vernon Burrell. Nora Jean Lorianne Burrell. Madison Dawn Overby. Skylar Aiko Sakamoto Howell. Abigail Jaslyn Boyer. Gunner Jean Ani. James David Gilchrist. Nicholas Cullen Calavano. Monty Ray Erickson. Joseph Anthony Beats. Austin Kenneth Dobiez. Isaac Ruben Erickson. Thank you. Gavin Ray Hammer.
Let's hear it one more time for our class of 2020. Congratulations. So we're a little ahead of schedule. That's fine. I told the people who are going to hopefully meet us in town at 12:15-ish. So if there's an opportunity now, now's your photo op opportunity. But we also have another little song we'd like to play for our graduates.
Down the street, he says, why am I soft in the middle now? Why am I soft in the middle? The rest of my life is so hard. I need a photo opportunity. I want a shot of redemption. Don't want to end up a cartoon in a cartoon graveyard. Bone digger, bone digger, dogs in the moonlight. Far away in my well-lit door. Mr. Beer Melly, Beer Melly, get these mutts away from me, you know. I don't find this stuff amusing anymore. If you'll be my bodyguard, I can be your long lost pal. I can call you Betty, and Betty, when you call me, you can call me Al. A man walks down the street, he says, why am I short of attention? Got a short little span of attention, and oh, my nights are so long. Where's my wife and family? What if I die here? Who'll be my role model now that my role model is gone, gone? He ducked back down the alley with some roly-poly little bat-faced girl. All along, along, there were incidents and accidents. There were hints and allegations. If you'll be my bodyguard, I can be your long-lost pal. I can call you Daddy, and Daddy when you call me.
Spinning in infinity, he says, amen, hallelujah, if you'll be my bodyguard.